Hello, 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 hello. Another high school problem. I have a spring whose mass can be ignored. That may be a little bit artificial, but we will ignore it. In the future, I will probably do some problems whereby the mass of the spring cannot be ignored. But here, it can be ignored. I put this spring on a horizontal surface which is frictionless. The spring has length capital L and spring constant K. Capital L is the complete relaxed length of the spring. So there is no force acting on the spring at all, other than of course gravity, but no force in this direction. And in that state, L is 60 centimeters. It's about this long. I now hang this spring from the ceiling. So here is that spring, and I put a mass M at the end, and I hold it right here, the mass, so that this is still length L. Of course, if I let it go, it would go down. But I stop it here. So this length L is this length L. This is the spring now. I now push my hand up. I push the mass M up over a distance D. And that distance is 4 centimeters. And now I pull my hand off and your object will go down. And mass M will come to a halt here. So right here, the speed is zero. And what I want you to calculate is what this H is, capital H. So from this point, when I pull my hand off, it comes to a halt here. I want that H. Let's all use for G 10 meters per second square. The spring constant K is 10 newtons per meter. And the mass M is 0.2 kilograms. Now, you can only ignore the mass of the spring if its mass is much, much less than the mass of M. That may be a little artificial here, because a spring with length 60 centimeters, which has a mass much, much less than 200 grams, that may not be so easy. But today, I'll make it easy. So today, we will ignore the mass of the spring. All right, it is a high school problem. What is capital H? You can give it to me in centimeters or in meters. If you give it in centimeters, I would like 2-digit precision. That will be accurate enough. Okay then. Take care, have a nice day, and by all means, let's be friends as we always were and as we always will be.